JOIDES Resolution is one of two drilling ships run by the Integrated Ocean Drilling Program, or IODP. It's been operating since mid-2009, since it was totally recommissioned. The Integrated Ocean Drilling Program investigates the history of the planet through taking drill cores from the sea floor, from beneath the sea floor. It operates two vessels that travel around the oceans. It's the biggest geoscience project in the world, and New Zealand has had a long history of getting information from the program. A lot of the climate history for the New Zealand region, the geological timescale is all based on the results of ocean drilling. In this time of concern about climate change, we've got the ship here now investigating the relationship between climate change and sea level change and local processes like the uplift of the Southern Alps and sedimentary deposition offshore Canterbury. The JOIDES Resolution is a state-of-the-art drilling ship. It has a drilling tower that allows it to drill through several kilometres of seawater into the seafloor and then several kilometres beneath the seafloor. As well as that, it has a state-of-the-art laboratory, a full science lab on board that allows up to 30 to 35 scientists work full-time, 24 hours a day, for every two-month expedition. So when the core comes back from the seafloor, it's laid out in the drill ship and the cores are split and opened up and a working half is examined by a group of scientists. First off, the sedimentologists will have a good look at it and describe the sedimentary features of the rocks. There'll be samples taken, the cores will be logged so that the physical parameters of the sediment can be recorded, the magnetic properties of the sediment can be recorded. The samples taken will go to the paleontologists, who will take the microscopic fossils out of the sediment and determine from the fossils what age the sediments are and what kind of environment they were deposited in. The main thing they'll be looking at with the sediments from the Canterbury expedition are the cycles in the sediments, so the changes from sand to silt to clay and how they can relate these cycles to climate cycles or sea level cycles. We know that through Earth history there have been periods of ice advance, ice retreat, so the ice ages have come and gone. To be able to document the timing of these climate events and the consequent sea level changes, what they'll be interested to do specifically in relation to this expedition is to put some parameters on the rates of change and the scales of change. So how much sea levels fell and rose in response to climate change and how rapidly they changed.